In our last video, we looked at theory behind Word2Vec. This is part 2 of that video and we are going to do coding here. So we will be using Amazon product review for cell phone accessories and build a Word2Vec model in a GenSim library. I know this is the tutorial series for TensorFlow, but GenSim library is an NLP library for Python, and it's very easy to use. The syntax is very easy compared to TensorFlow, so that's why we are going to use that and train a model. So I have given the outline of the whole video here, so there will be coding and there will be an exercise as well in the end. Let us begin. Alrighty, so let's first install GenSim library. So you can just do pip install GenSim and it will install it. I already have this installed. You need to install another module called Python Levenstein. So just copy paste and install it. By the way, if you uncomment this line and run this cell, it will install as well. Now I have imported GenSim and Pandas, and I'm going to download Amazon product reviews dataset, and these are the product reviews especially for cell phone accessories category. So if you click on this, what's going to happen is it is going to download, you see 43 megabyte file here in this particular folder, and I'm going to open that folder. So show in the folder and Control X. Okay, so I am going to now put that here, Control V. So this is a zipped file. Okay, GZ is a zip file version and you need to unzip it. So your data set needs to be unzipped by running this command. G unzip command. Okay, G unzip command. You go to that particular folder and run it on that GZ file and it will unzip the file. You see, now I have this huge JSON file. By the way, I'm not trying to open this file because it's 135 megabyte. It's a very big file. Okay, now this has JSON records with all product reviews, and Pandas actually support reading JSON file. Okay, so that's what we're going to do here, and we're going to create a data frame. So here df is equal to pd dot read json, name of the file all right, and lines equal to true. So if you don't know the meaning of lines equal to true, you can go here shift tab, it will open the documentation, and when I read the documentation, see the lines, it will say that it will read the JSON object, read the file as a JSON object per line. So one line is one JSON object in that particular file. Again, I'm not opening that file in Notepad because it is very huge and it's probably going to hang in the Notepad editor. I'm going to just print a couple of rows of that data frame, and you can see there is a reviewer ID, some identification number as in reviewer name, helpful. You know, in Amazon, people say, okay, it was zero, two people found it useful out of three. So it is that tuple. And there is a review text here. Okay. And overall rating looks good, whatever. So these are all the cell phone accessories. And we are going to train a Word2Vec model using only a review text. So we are interested only in this column. Remaining columns are not useful to us. Now I will do df.shape just to get an idea on how many records. You see, we have 194,000 records. That's a lot of data actually. All right, so that data set is enough to train our model. And now see, when you have this review text, so let me just do df.review text. So this is the column we are interested in, okay? And if you look at any review, see the review is like, okay, they look good and stick good, whatever. The first step in training Word2Vec model is to do
pre-processing, because these texts have things like, you know, a and the, these are the stop words that they have, for example, a and the, it. So we don't want those. And the another thing is, you know, we want to convert this word into lowercase so that, you know, everything is in lowercase and comparable. Then remove the trailing spaces, you know, removing punctuation marks and so on. And all of these things can be done using a function in GenSim. So GenSim library, so we have already imported in GenSim, right? Has utils dot simple preprocess. Now this function will simply preprocess this particular text. Just to show you, let me copy paste this particular review text into simple process function and let's see what it will do with it. So you see, it is tokenizing the sentence, meaning they, T was capital, it converted all to lowercase, then look good and stick good. See, the good had this punctuation mark which it removed, then it removed I as well, because when you're building Word2Vec model, things like I, the, these are not very useful. Then in don't, it removed punctuation mark and T. Now it's not very perfect, by the way, so it is using some simple heuristic rules for doing this pre-processing, but this is good enough to build our Word2Vec model. So I used one sentence here, but if you want to use the entire column, you can do apply function. So here, see, I have this review text function, right? So on this review text function, if I do apply this function, okay, if I apply this function, what's going to happen is it's going to return me a new NumPy series. You know, pandas column is a series object. So pandas series object basically, and I will call it review text. Let's print that here. So now it is applying this simple process function on all of our reviews. So we have 194,000 reviews. So for each of these reviews, it is applying that function and it is going to create a new pandas series. And you see each object in that series is a list. And the list has tokenized words. Now, if you remember from part one of this video, where we went over the theory of Word2Vec, there was a concept of a window. So when you have this kind of statement, you take a window, moving window. So here, this window is of size 2, okay? Because you are there is this word A, and then you're taking a word before and after, okay? So when you do this thing, this kind of thing, king, order, his. So there is order, his, and there is king. So there is, so this is called a context window. So you keep on moving this window and you generate your training samples. So here my training samples are, see, lived A, and then it will, the target is there. So target is there, and this is your, these are your context words. So context words and the target, context words and target. So when you have paragraph of text, you can generate these kind of training samples. And I highly suggest that you go through this particular video, part one. So let me just show you. So this was the part one, what is Word2Vec. So it's very, very important that you go through it to understand the theory first, because otherwise understanding code will be hard for you. Okay, now we are going to initialize a GenSim model. So in GenSim, GenSim.models, GenSim is an NLP library and it comes with Word2Vec class. Okay, so now I'm going to create a model using this. Okay, now this takes a couple of parameters. Okay, what kind of parameter does it take? First parameter is window. So window is equal to 10. So what is the window? Window is this thing. This is the window. Okay. So when I say 10, it means 10 words before your target word and 10 words after your target word. You can experiment with the size. There is no fixed rule. You can make it 5, 7, whatever. Then there is another thing called mean count. So mean count is basically if you have a sentence which has only one word, then don't use that sentence. At least two words need to be present in the sentence in order to be considered for the training. Workers is how many CPU threads you want to use to train this model. So I said 4, my CPU has 4 cores, so I will be using 4 threads. Okay. Now we need to build a vocabulary. Building vocabulary means building unique list of words. And again, if you have seen my previous videos, you will get an idea. So I will call a function called build vocab. By the way, I know about these functions, but if you don't know, you can just Google it. You can Google GenSim's document. So let me just show you GenSim documentation. And here you find the documentation. So if you are doing build vocab, so build vocab will have some examples they would have given here. So build vocab. See, so you can look at the parameters. There is this parameter called progress per, which means when you are training a model, after how many words you want to see a progress bar or progress update. So progress per, let's say 1,000 words. Okay, now it is training the model, and no, this is building a vocabulary. By the way, I don't know, because of Jupyter Notebook, the way it is set up, it did not show me the progress bar, but that's probably okay. All right, so it initialized a model. Now let's look at this model. So model has things like epoch. So by default, the epochs are set to 5. So what I'm going to do now is perform the actual training. So we'll do model.train. Okay, now what kind of parameter does it take? Obviously, it will take review text first. So see, review text. So review text. Then total examples. Okay, how many total examples do we have? Well, it will be equal to model.corpuscount. Model.corpus count is total examples. How many total examples we had? 194,000. All right. And then epochs is equal to model.epochs. Epoch, again, if you have seen my previous deep learning video, you will know what epochs means. It is how many times you want to iterate through the entire data set. And when I do the training, now it's gonna go through all those 194,000 sentences and build my word to vec model. So the training is going on right now while I'm talking. It might take time based on your computer, your CPU, GPU. I'm not sure it will be using GPU though, but it's a big data set, so you have to be patient. Okay, my model is trained, and I'm going to first save the model to some file, because usually what they do is train a model, save it to a file, and then use that pre-trained model in most of the occasions. Okay, so I'm going to, let's say, call it this dot model. And if you look at my, not this, but this, see, dot model. So I have saved this model. Now I can take this model, deploy it to cloud, and kind of use it for my NLP needs. All right, so I just saved the model. I'm not going to use that model yet, saved model, because I already have model loaded in the memory. Okay, so I'm going to now experiment. So the way you experiment is you do model.word2vec. Okay, word2vec, and it has a function called most similar. So let's say there are product reviews and someone is saying a word bad. So what are the words which are similar to bad? You see, that is wonderful. So bad and terrible, and this is a similarity score. You see, shabby, horrible. Now, good is similar in a sense that good and bad are antonyms, but they're kind of in a similar category. Okay, so that's what it is showing. If you train this on an even bigger data set, then it will be even more accurate. So this is not very perfect, but you kind of see the power of this model. You know, after training it, it can now start understanding the language. It knows which words is similar to which other word. All right, and then we can print a similarity score as well, cosine similarity. So you can print similarity score between two words, let's say cheap and inexpensive. Another one I would like to try is great and good. See, the similarity is higher. And if I do great and let's say product. See, great and product are not very, so minus means, see, they're not very similar. But great and good, or great and let's say awesome. You see, this is already working so cool. 0.73 is a higher score. 0.1 means like they're exactly same. 0.1, let's see. See, one and great is exactly same. So it says one, but great and good, great and nice. This is already working fine, but great and iPhone, 0.09, see, so very less. All right, you can do further reading on this by going to official documentation of GenSim. Again, GenSim is a very popular NLP library. We are doing this video as part of Keras and TensorFlow series, but GenSim is very easy to use in terms of training Word2Vec model. That's why I showed GenSim here. And there is an exercise for you. This is an important thing. So you need to train a Word2Vec model on sports and outdoors reviews dataset. So if you open that dataset again, 65 megabyte dataset, and you have to build a similar notebook. And after you're done building it, click on the solution. So don't click on the solution until you have done your due diligence, okay? And this notebook is available on my GitHub. I'm going to provide a page of my GitHub. So this is my GitHub, by the way. And if you go to deep learning, and if you go to Word2Vec, this is the notebook which I covered in the video. And towards the end, there is an exercise. And if you click on the solution, it has a solution, but you're not going to click on the solution because you know what's going to happen if you click on the solution without trying on your own. Your computer will start burning. There is a curse, you know. So you make sure your computer doesn't burn. You try things on your own before you look at my solution. I hope you found this video is useful. If you did, share it with your friends. Try it out. Maybe try it out on different data set. Try to build your own Word2Vec model to understand the power of it. Thank you. Have a nice day.